Today we're going to talk about this man right here and why he is the greatest quarterback to ever play the game. Aaron Rodgers is one of the greatest quarterbacks to ever play because he is doing incredible things this year. Specifically, he is attacking the flat and the fades. And I'm going to show you why he's doing it, why he's having so much success, and everything about that. But first, we actually have to define what the flat is, because it is a lot of coaches don't understand that concept. Seriously, I asked my followers on Twitter what the flat means to them, and these are the responses I got. See, these are very smart coaches on Twitter that actually coach football, not just some slappies that are just doing this on the internet. And they don't even have a common language for what the flat actually means to them and their offense. So for us to show you why Aaron Rodgers is the GOAT, we're going to have to decide what the flat really is. So here's a picture of what someone showed me during Twitter. And what we're going to say is these are the flats right here, this area. The flat for us is going to be anything outside of the number two wide receiver about 5 yards down the field. That is what constitutes a flat in this scenario in this video. You see, Aaron Rodgers is just not attacking the flats or the fades in this example, in this season. He's actually done this his entire career. And I'm going to show you some stats where a lot of his touchdowns comes from the 5 yard and back or 30 plus. And here it is, just so I'm not pulling anything out my ass. Pro Football Reference actually shows Aaron Rodgers with this phenomenal photo right there with his beard, has thrown for 449 touchdowns. Of those touchdowns, 91 of them have been 3 or less, and 89 of them have been 30 yards or more. So he has loved throwing things to the flat and to the fades his entire career, but that's not it, okay? I had to actually write this down because this was mind-blowing. 23% of his completions this year have been in the flats. 5% of his completions have been fade balls. Combined, around 30% has been either to the flats or fade balls this entire season, which is incredible. And the crazy thing about it, 13.5% of his fades ended up in touchdowns, which is insane because Aaron Rodgers is the freaking GOAT. So we're gonna cover some of his favorite flat concepts, and I noticed something watching film, that these throws came up, the same plays, but different little tweaks over and over again. I know this technically isn't a throw to the flat, but since this is the NFL and since this is one of my favorite pass plays, the touch pass to the running back is a way to attack the flat, and it's a simple way for him to get a cheap yards and get a touchdown. Another way they did it is they used a lot of running back motion and they would push the guy out. And as you can tell, Rodgers is looking at this defender right here, has him open up to Devontae Adams, and then he throws it, a swing pass to the running back, which again is in the flat, attacking it, a simple completion, and it does damage. This is a play that you will see over and over again when you study Green Bay, and what Aaron Rodgers likes to do is he likes to leak the running back into the flat right here and have everybody essentially run slants and creates a pick, and everybody loses where the running back is. As you can tell, everyone's running some form of mesh and you hit them in the flat. And it really works when you are doing this because the running back will get lost, and I'll show you that later on. One of Aaron Rodgers' favorite things to do is to motion and to get matchups with Devontae Adams. And here's a nice little one where he will come across, he will pause, and then he will come right back. And this opens it up because the defense is in man-to-man, they switch, and then a nice, simple dump off into the flats. Again, it's not anything difficult. You're just getting your playmaker to throw the ball to his best player. Here's an example of them throwing the running back into the flats again. It's an easy read for Aaron Rodgers. You get the completion, you move the ball, and you make defenses pay attention to the running back. Here you have Aaron Rodgers against the Steelers. You're running 3 receivers off, and then what do you know? You have the running back in the flats again for an easy completion 3 yards down the field that turns into 15. Same play against the Bengals this time. You got the running back into the flat. They're picking, everybody else is picking them off. A simple throw and a touchdown. Again, I cannot stress this enough. Aaron Rodgers is attacking the flats every single game It's a combination of wide receivers and running backs, and they're not difficult throws. The way that they have designed their passing concept, it's a really quick read for what Aaron Rodgers has to do, and it allows him to get the ball out and protect the ball. And this is one of the reasons why he only has 4 interceptions the entire season. The beautiful thing also about what Aaron Rodgers does is when he is going through his progressions, 1, 2, 3, if he can't find anybody open, he always finds his running back, which again is in the flats for a simple check down slash touchdown. I know you're getting sick of seeing the touchdowns to the running back in the flat, so let's show Davante Adams getting one-on-one coverage, beating his man and taking it to the flat. Again, not a very difficult throw for Aaron Rodgers, but he is a Hall of Fame quarterback. That's a Hall of Fame wide receiver. You're getting his guy on your guy. It is a nice and easy catch, and it works. Here is a running shoot concept called Thunder, where the number one goes vertical and number 2 and 3 running out. And as you can tell, this is a simple throw and catch for Aaron Rodgers and Lazar, which results in another touchdown. This is not a deep throw. It's 5 yards. He throws it on a dime, yes, but it is attacking the flats again, which causes the defense to do something. So what does it cause the defense to do? Well, when you are attacking the flats over and over again, 5 yards, you then have the defense press up, and then that's where you throw the fade. And this is a beautiful thing that Aaron Rodgers does. Is probably one of the best quarterbacks to ever play the game to throw the fade ball. And let me show you what I'm talking about. Here you have one high safety, and then this guarantees that you have one-on-one matchup you need with your... Here you are against the Steelers, and when you're in the red zone, what do you normally think they do? They attack the flat. So Aaron Rodgers knows that. He brings motion across, and then he gets the one-on-one, and he throws the back shoulder fade, which is unguardable in this situation, for a touchdown. This is what you do when you attack the flats over and over again. In the red zone again, you've got a one-on-one right down here with your best and most favorite wide receiver of all time, so you know you have to take a shot. That's exactly what he does. Back shoulder, perfect placement, because he is a Hall of Fame quarterback, and that is a Hall of Fame wide receiver, and that's what you do when you attack the flats. You are getting these favorable matchups that you've got to exploit. When you attack down the field and you have one of your best wide receivers, you get double coverage. As you can see, the safety at the top right here, he's getting double coverage on Davante Adams. So you're a guaranteed single receiver one-on-one coverage here. You will notice number 2, wide open, boom. That is a fade throw. You're picking your best matchup. You can do that down here when you execute on the fades into the flats. And this is just a great throw and catch. Notice the defender can't defend that because it is thrown at his helmet. Perfect ball placement for a fade touchdown. Hey, real quick, if you like this, please go ahead and subscribe. That lets me know that, hey, these videos are fun, I enjoy watching them, and I want more of them. Now let's get back to the very next fade against the Bears, because Aaron Rodgers owns them. Sometimes you just feel it, and right here, Aaron Rodgers feels it with your wide receiver, and you have just connected on the fade balls over and over and over again. But wait, what happens when you are just killing them on the fades, killing them in the flat? What do you do as an offensive play caller? Well, you hit up the adjustments. And the Packers and Aaron Rodgers have done a really good job of making a couple of adjustments that catch the defense off guard, and I'm gonna show you those. The first adjustment that you can do is when you guarantee that you are just hitting the fade over and over again, you're gonna hit up the little fade and slant, which is exactly what Davante Adams does. He sets up his defender, looking like he is gonna run his fade, opens his hips, snaps it underneath for a nice slant. Again, watch how the defender, the cornerback, opens his hips. His hips are open, meaning they're pointing to the sideline. That is a man hip angle. See how he commits right there? And he's like, oh crap. Davante Adams plants, comes underneath for the slant. That is the first adjustment you can make against the fade. When you attack the flat as much as the Green Bay Packers do and Aaron Rodgers, you can then adjust by having to fake the flat throw and hit a slant underneath. And this is what happens right here. You have motion, he is going across to look like he is going to run the flat, and then you have Randall Cobb who's doing a stutter block and slant. And when you have that, you have a simple pitch and catch with your Hall of Fame quarterback. But I want you to see what it does to the defense. If we freeze it, you can see that you have 1, 2, 3, 4. defenders staring at the flat route, which opens up the slant right behind it. And that is a nice adjustment to have if you are attacking the flat as much as Green Bay is doing. Here is the same play that you saw against the Detroit Lions, three wide receivers bunch. You're going to have the running back slip into the flats over here to the three receiver side. But when he is not there, when no one is open, he goes up. And when you run the same play over and over again, you can have these little adjustments of the flat and up like that. And you take advantage of defensive coordinators that know your tendencies and are trying to play the play. You're one step ahead of them. And this is what Aaron Rodgers and the Packers are actually great at. So what does this mean? It means that the Packers are probably going to attack the 49ers in the flat, and when Aaron Rodgers gets those one-on-one situations, he's going to take it deep. And I expect them to exploit that to a T. And hey, if you love this video, you're going to love this one right here, and I'll see you later.